Next on C-SPAN, on Friday, President Obama was in Seoul, South Korea for the annual G20 conference, where he met privately with Chinese President Hu Jintao.
Good afternoon. Thank you. Thank you. Earlier today, representatives of the world's 20 largest economies concluded the full session of the annual G20 conference, after which President Hu and I were able to meet privately. We had an extraordinarily frank and wide-ranging discussion on a variety of topics, from trade practices to currency devaluation to fair labor standards to global climate change. I left convinced that relations between the United States and China remain strong and will only grow stronger. President Hu.
Thank you, President Obama. President Obama is absolutely correct. In our meeting, we spoke candidly about a wide array of issues, everything under the sun. No topic was off limits. You name it, we covered it. In fact, and correct me if I'm wrong, the only thing we didn't talk about is the matter of your country owing China a great deal of money. About $800 billion, actually. Strangely, that is the one subject we did not discuss.
The United States is well aware of its debt to China.
I kept waiting for you to bring it up. And when you didn't, I thought to myself, did they already pay us back and I just forgot? Or perhaps the money arrived after I left for this conference. But I checked with my office and they haven't received it.
As President Hu will recall, we discussed this issue a year ago. As I said at the time, the United States fully intends to honor its debts.
So, did you bring the check?
I promise you, you're going to get your money.
All right, then that's good enough for me. But say, do you mind if we turn off the lights?
I'm sorry, I do not understand.
I like to have the lights off when someone is doing sex to me.
Please, Mr. President. Let's not have this again. Obviously, it's no secret that my country's recovery from the recession has been slower than expected.
We know all about your economic problems. That's why we were so surprised to see you embark on this 10-day vacation to Asia that is costing $200 million a day.
Now, hold on. I don't know where you heard that, but this trip is not costing $200 million a day.
That's not what Glenn Beck says.
Again, let me be clear. Glenn Beck has no idea what he's talking about.
He was right about buying gold.
I think we're getting off the subject.
My government should have bought gold. Unfortunately, all our assets were tied up in U.S. Treasury bills.
I know.
I understand your next stop is Japan.
That's right. We leave for Tokyo tonight.
Please tell me you don't owe them money, too.
Mr. President, my country will repay all its foreign creditors. No nation will be shortchanged.
Okay, that's all I needed to hear. I'm not worried anymore. But just do me one favor. Would you gently bite the back of my neck?
Please, there's really no need for this.
I'll tell you why I ask. I like to have my neck bitten when someone is doing sex to me.
Please, Mr. President.
Tell me, when you finish this trip and do finally get back to America, exactly how do you plan to restore your nation's economy so we can get our money?
As I've said many times, the solution to my country's economic problems lies in the new green economy. Good, high-paying green jobs are the answer.
Green jobs.
Yes, green jobs.
Have you, by any chance, mistaken me for Miss Universe?
I'm sorry?
Have you mistaken me for Miss Universe?
Of course not.
Then why do you insist on doing sex to me as if I were Miss Universe?
Mr. President, once again, there is really no need.
You know, at a certain point, it's not even about the $800 billion. It's more the lack of respect.
Mr. President, don't do this.
Go ahead. Be as rough as you like.
I'm asking you to stop.
You can pull my hair or choke me too. I don't care anymore. I just want it to be over.
Mr. President, please stop. I beg of you.
Very well. We can continue this later. In the meantime, live from New York, it's Saturday night!